Hi, this is Case, and I help people from doing to being. And today I'm here with you with a video about passive acceptance versus active acceptance. And let me first of all explain to you what acceptance really is. So acceptance, there's a lot of talk, of course, about accepting things, and you just have to accept it. People talk about, when things are tough, you just have to accept them, right? And what they mean is actually, which I find a very much more productive explanation of accepting, is actually not resisting. So you can't really do acceptance. Acceptance is actually a non-doing. And it's the non-doing of resistance. It's the non-doing of trying to fix or change or trying to... resist it. It's not accepting it. It's not really seeing it for what it is. So there, and that's a mental thing. It's not per se that when you accept things you don't do anything about them. No, that's something different. It's when you accept it, you not resist it, and you act from that. So that means when I break my toe, if I accept it, I do not mentally resist it or think about how I could have changed that or how I should have not bumped my toe or blah, 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 or what of an idiot I am, blah, 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 blah. You don't do that. What you do is very simply you accept that this has happened and you act and do the necessary things, like go to maybe to the emergency room, go to the doctor, fix your toe, let it heal properly, maybe get some good shoes to to walk or get some crutches or anything that's necessary, or maybe cancel some appointments. But you let it go. You do not mentally resist it. And that's a very important thing to do. So acceptance to me is very crucial, because you basically have a sort of rule for yourself where you don't waste time unproductively analyzing or resisting the thing that already is here, the thing that already is. So acceptance to me is very crucial, and acceptance is one of the things to me winners do. And it's something you see as, let's say, from spirituality and Zen Buddhism and mindfulness, but also right until, let's say, personal development, where they say don't waste time on things that are already there, right? Analyze them, learn from them, move on. Do not waste time in resistance, because anything at time you're in resistance with life cannot flow through you from a spiritual perspective. Life cannot happen through you, just holding on to the thing that is already there. And you always want to be in a state of openness and flow. You don't want to be in a state of constrictiveness. One of my spiritual teachers, John de Ruyter, who's a guy based in Canada, with a Dutch name, but he's not Dutch. He says the constricted phase, or the constricted or the tightening of the fist, or the ego, you could say, is different in everybody, but the openness is the same in everybody. It's the same. So I encourage people to open, and one way to open is to not resist and to accept what is. And then you have two styles of acceptance, which is what this video is about. So that's passive versus active acceptance. And passive acceptance is, to me, is a sort of, is not a very productive way to accept. Because it's usually acceptance as a way, okay, let's say, passive acceptance is, to me, I'm thinking about a good example, but let's say you have an appointment coming up, which you really don't like, which you don't feel, which doesn't feel good to you, and you sort of say, well, you know, I accept it, it has to be done, you know, it's a thing, I'm just going to do it. even though it doesn't feel good, even though it doesn't feel right, even though it might be something which is not productive or effective or nice for you, or which feels against the flow or against the grain of your life. And you just, well, I'll just accept it, right? That's to me is a sort of passive acceptance. You accept it, but you do not act on the things you need to act on. So let's say I see this a lot with, let's say, people sometimes in my family that I make aware of certain issues that they might have. Let's say a limitation of, I need to do something to be loved, let's say. Instead of just loving yourself or letting yourself be loved, the idea of I need to do something to be loved, right? And when you're made accepted, let's say you become aware that this is not a productive thing for you, right? Because you have this whole cycle of conditional self-love, which is can be very destructive. If you have the idea, I need to do something to be loved, then you end up trying to do something because everybody wants to be loved, you know, even though this is something you should give yourself instead of being dependent on somebody else. Let's say I make you aware of this, maybe by me saying this, it makes you aware of this. And if you say, okay, well, I just accept that I'm like this, then there's no possibility for growth. Right, that's why there's a balance between self-acceptance and, to me, self-improvement. Because, to me, acceptance is not wasting time on what already is, but then moving forward and acting on the things that are not in line with how you want to feel or how the balance you deserve. So, and this asks a little bit of, let's say, higher standards of yourself, but also a little bit of personal leadership or empowerment on your part to make it into an active acceptance. And active acceptance, to me, is that you accept it, you don't resist what is, and then you act on the things that require your action. Let's say in this case, we talk about the limitation where you're self-love is conditional, then you go in and you find what made your self-love conditional and you act on that. And maybe that's not relevant for you today, maybe, or let's say it's relevant because it's an issue, but maybe it's not convenient for you to do today, then maybe you do it tomorrow or the day afterwards, but you understand this is a big thing in my life and I'm gonna work on this because I have the self-worth and the even though I have the acceptance, I also accept that this will not change unless I work on it, right? So active acceptance to me is that you first of all don't resist what is and then act on it, and especially if it feels out of alignment. And knowing from a non-dual perspective, we are spiritual beings living a temporal physical experience through this body, and even though in this body and our experience can be hard and can have its, you know, its challenges, a lot of the mental part can definitely be, let's say, worked on or be let go of, especially the resistance of that. And that's something we can do something about. And what we can do about that is actively accepting it, acting on it, or in this case, going to the issue, feeling where the issue or the pain is inside you, looking inside your psyche, maybe with meditation or using exercises of letting go, or maybe booking a session with somebody that can help you with that. For example, hypnotherapist or somebody that works with the matrix technologies, matrix energetics, or quantum touch, or any type of healer if you don't want to do it yourself. That's also acceptance from acting, like, okay, I have this issue and I want it to be acted, I want to act on it. Or I have this issue and I feel that it's a big thing, especially if my self-love is conditional, like I just said, that's a big thing. And then I want to do something about that. Not from a place that I need to do something about that, that I feel bad about it, but from a place, I'm okay, I'm good, but I'm going to work on this because this does not belong here. I know my self-love, I deserve my own love unconditionally, and that's what I'm going to work on. That's active acceptance to me. I hope I've been clear in explaining this. And I wish you a lot of acceptance, and I wish you active acceptance where, especially in the mental space, you go in and you let go of the resistance. That's active acceptance in the mental space, right? Sometimes that's letting go of the resistance and then doing an action in the physical world. But lots of times it's, for example, doing a regression or going back to the place of hurt or trauma inside you and letting go of the resistance, which come often in the form of emotions. So try to let go, try to actively accept, and remove the resistance. And I'm still evolving, and I wanted to really share this with you, and let's evolve together. Much love, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.